Well, his amazing showbiz career spans more than four decades. Mark Holden was a teen idol in the early days, but in later years, life was no easy ride for him. Craig Bennett caught up with the amazing Mark Holden.
He went from the carnation kid of the 70s to a hot young character in The Young Doctors.
It's all my stupid fault.
Wasn't it, you know?
What?
Did it deliberately?
Then coining a catchphrase in reality TV. Until it all came crashing down with a creepy clown. But let's take the story back over 40 years when teen idol Mark Holden got his start and a record deal. The heights of stardom thanks to Countdown and his trademark flower. But why a carnation for the object of his affection and not a rose?
I thought, what can I do? Well, there's going to be girls there. You bring a flower. Well, what flower? A rose? No, I don't want to prick the young virgins. How about a carnation?
Here's the carny.
What I had was a red one, so it had the sort of this red bulb, let's say.
As it were.
As it were.
You did for carnations what Damien did for gladioli,
correct,
didn't you? It's, well, quite true.
Absolutely correct, because Mum used to take me to see Barry Humphreys, and to this day I love Barry Humphreys. And I remember going to Her Majesty's Theatre in Adelaide and getting the glads. So, yes, this was definitely...
So you stole that from Barry Humphreys?
I most certainly did.
Ada bet me 50 cents I couldn't take you to Bunny's place tonight.
Ada just lost 50 cents.
He was making hit records, but could he also make a success of acting in the TV drama The Young Doctors, where he played the dashing Dr. Greg Mason?
Dead set, honest truth, Craig. Probably is. I didn't look at him until the morning I turned up, I would imagine.
Were you a good actor back then?
Nah, shocking. Absolutely shocking.
Oh, I love true confessions.
Shocking. Although, must be said, as bad as it was, it's probably some of my best work.
And he had another confession about the woman who played young Kitty on another 70s TV success, The Sullivans.
Susan Hannaford and I were an item back in those days.
Kitty?
Yes.
And Greg?
Kitty and...
This is shocking.
Isn't that fantastic?
This is scandalous.
This is scandalous.
In 1980, Mark moved to America for more than a decade, working with names like The Temptations, Fleetwood Mac and Donny Osmond. But by the 90s, with a wife and young daughter, he decided to come home. However, the music didn't stop, with Mark launching Vanessa Amorosi onto the scene in 2000 with a song he co-wrote for her. You can give your life, you can lose your soul.
You can bang your head or you can drown in a hole. Nothing lasts forever, but you can try. Look around you. Everyone you see, everyone you know is gone.
It was about this time things went dark for Mark as he faced a major health battle which had a devastating effect.
I had thyroid cancer and I got into the neck, and so I had a number of surgery, cut it all out, beautiful, but I've lost probably, I'd say, 70-80% of my voice.
Mark knew he'd beat it, but with a father who'd suffered prostate cancer and a sister diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, Mark's message on medical matters is clear.
50% of doctors that you go to that will tell a young bloke, don't worry about it, too much testing, blah, blah, blah. If you've got a doctor like that, find another doctor. Save your life.
Bouncing back, Australian Idol came a-calling in 2003 with what he calls the best job he ever had.
I remember the moment hearing Jessica Malloy up in Alice Springs and going, oh, my God, what a glorious girl. You know, wow.
Was a touchdown.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, sublime.
And touchdown became his catchphrase for Idol. But after five seasons, the song was over for Mark.
They wanted me out so badly, they paid me not to be on the show. It was fantastic.
Like balloons, Danny.
He wasn't finished with reality TV, and even though he's happy to admit he can't dance, Mark appeared on Dancing with the Stars.
I could get you a balloon, Danny.
Wanting to push the boundaries, some would argue too far, he danced on the show as a creepy clown.
There were a lot of people who enjoyed it, but there were probably five times more who hated it. I was getting messages saying, you know, I used to have your picture on my wall. I would, you know, you are disgusting. You know.
Really?
Oh my God, it was an avalanche.
But Mark is now well equipped to handle that sort of response. He's a barrister and can perform in the courtroom as well as he does for friends.
I won't make you my lady, make you my lady, then you'll be forever mine, girl.
Wow. Another cracker from Craig Bennett. And as you just saw, Mark is back singing again. In fact, he and his brother Craig will be performing together in concert at the Adelaide Fringe in... Fantastic. Is it Fringe or Fridge?
Fringe,
yeah, in February next year.
I'm actually performing in a fridge.
It's a really big fridge that they're going to be performing in. Go to Mark's official Facebook page for more details.